We're Katie Monthy, Jenny Matthews, Kayla Morton, and Lizzie Williams. For our Civic Action Project, we chose cyberbullying. We are very aware that cyberbullying is a huge problem throughout the nation, and we wanted to do something about it. Through three steps and a lot of talking, we think we have succeeded.
About you all, but the statistic, what did you just say? 98% of students reported seeing an act of bullying, but not one student said they were a bully.
For our first step, we took a survey of how many people have been cyberbullied in Athelton. We sent out our surveys to all grade levels and a variety of classes. The surveys were sent to band, weightlifting, science, and in the hallways as well.
We asked the student body if they had ever been cyberbullied, if they had seen cyberbullying happen, and what technology was used, like Facebook or Twitter. We also asked for personal stories of cyberbullying if they were comfortable telling us.
The results were astonishing. Although 21.3% said that they had been bullied, 65.8% had said that they had witnessed someone else being cyberbullied.
The stories that we read were even worse. Many accounts included nude pictures and name-calling. The worst reports talked of rude comments that led to self-harm, suicide attempts, and eventually suicide itself. Out of the 60 written responses, three of them had known someone who had tried to commit suicide or had succeeded. That's a lot of student deaths. And this a dark, uneasy time. And if you have something to say, you better say it now.
For our second action, we had an announcement over the intercom broadcasting a school-wide awareness day. We asked the school to wear blue to support the prevention of cyberbullying. Many people participated, including those from other schools. Trap dress, we won't do it all. I spent so long trying to fit the prototype, I kept on slipping in the gears and I never got it right. Oh, what's the use? What's the point? You got the wrong girl. Oh, so you can do what you're doing down there, cause I'll be flying higher. Waste your own time, I don't care.
You know, this is an issue that is tough for any community to get their arms around. We're here today because I think we need to do everything we can as a community to address this problem of bullying.
For our third and final action, we took a chance to try and contact our county executive, Ken Ulman. In mid-April, we emailed Mark Miller, Ken Ullman's secretary, to hopefully set up a meeting and interview to discuss cyberbullying. After playing email tag for a few weeks, we finally set a date.
So we searched the country, and we found a terrific web and smartphone-based app that allows real-time reporting about bullying wherever it happens.
One of the many things Ken Ullman told us in his interview was about this app called Spriggio.
Spriggio was launched recently to electronically find and stamp out cyberbullying. Using this app, kids, teens, and adults can write about a bullying problem. The statements will be sent to a call center where they will be sorted by location.
Spriggio will also be beneficial not only to the student body and their parents, who will be notified of the bullying, but to the county government and the school systems. The schools can then decide what to do from there.
How do you make sure that it's not abused? What he said was fascinating to me. He said less than 1% of the submissions were found to be false, and almost all of them happened at the beginning. It's very important to make sure that we have all platforms available. And it'll be available at libraries. It'll be available. There'll actually be signs at the library that'll talk about it. Public school system, although we've still got some work to do, I think, there. Leagues that have joined, the YMCA, Howard County, HCYP, places like that.
Sometimes it's important for your parents to know about, like, what's happening. So if you are thinking about, like, harming yourself or someone else in any way, like, how would they be able to find out about what's going on in your life so that they know how to help too?
The more data and information we can get, then the more chance there is that the right adults find out about what's happening and can help.
Even though we're high schoolers, we can make a difference. Through this project and our meeting with Mr. Ulman, we hope that cyberbullying will be completely stopped, even if it does take time.
We also hope that you, as a student, do your part to prevent the spread of bullying. If you see it, stop it. As cheesy as it sounds, don't be a bystander. Make a difference. As Gandhi once said, be the change that you wish to see in the world.